The chapter House is not a home and the chapter The Beggar. So I tell you all to pay attention, okay, so that you can learn and listen all the important facts at home. The what I have noticed is that you have not gone through a chapter at once. One of the tests I was checking for that what are the two strange things. The first thing that I want to mention here is that they don't write in points. In English, everything is to be written in a paragraph. Okay, many students, they have done that. Next point is that one test I have given is and a child was not knowing the spelling of 1, 2, but I did TOOBO. It means what it shows. I simply came to know the child has not read even a single page from the book.
Kind of the destroyer of the computer file.
Yes. It is what it is. It is DU. See. Chalo, come back to the chapter. So, house is not a home. What the chapter house is not a home is all about. The chapter house is not a home. It simplifies the second difference between a house and a home. Then the narrator of the story, his house was completely burnt. It was burnt down to ashes. He has lost his home house and moreover, his red tabby cat with whom he was sharing such a great and lovable relation was also lost. At that moment also, when his house was burnt, few days back, he has also joined a new high school, but he was not adjusting in that school. Okay. So, moreover, more and more problems are being forced over in his life. So, what this chapter on the underlying level, it exemplifies. It also simplifies the various problems of adolescence. Okay. During adolescent age, the children used to face a lot of, you can say, problems in order to adjust in the new environment. They face number of problems. They feel difficulty in adjusting in the new environment. And ultimately, then when his house was revived back, it was rebuilt again. He has come to know ultimately that another name of life is to make adjustment. We have to compromise. We have to make adjustment. Slowly and gradually, he has lost his house. It was built again. He has lost his cat. And finally, it was back. He has a loose relationship with his old school and ultimately the new school, he has got his new friend. So everything came back to the track again. Okay. So how the chapter starts? So then he has mentioned that after finishing his junior high school, he got admitted to the new high school, higher high school, senior high school. But in the senior high school, he was not able to adjust there because he was missing his old friends as well as his old teachers. Okay, he used to often go and pay a visit to his old school, meet the teachers and could narrate them that I'm not able to adjust in the new school. Even his teachers, they were always advising him that he should participate in some of the activities of the school. In that way, he will meet many new people and this will also help him to adjust. So here the question is, what advice was given to him by his teachers? Speak out.
To take part in
activities. If you have not gone through the chapter, please side by side answer the question. Okay, so that you will remember the thing. Okay, so that he could take part in the various activities. In this way, he could meet different kind of people and will make new friends. And they also assured him that in the coming time, he would be able to adjust in the new school and would miss the new school more than his previous school. Thus, you can come on that side on the first desk if you are not feeling like that. So, he said that he was missing his old teacher. So, next afterwards, this was his one, you can say, loose end of his, you can say, life in which he was feeling or he was having the sense of insecurity. Okay? So, there is a transformation of then from a feeling of insecurity to sense of security. How he was feeling secure later on, his life has transformed to a balanced one. How this happened? This we are going to learn. Okay. So then afterwards, he has mentioned his Sunday
afternoon. During one Sunday afternoon, he was sitting in the living area of his house where he was doing his homework. Okay, so one Sunday afternoon, what Bran was doing? He was doing his homework. Who was sitting along with him? His red tabby cat was sitting along with him. And what kind of sound was produced by the cat? It was purring again and again. Okay, what kind of sound was produced by the cat? Purring sound. Okay, right. So purring sound means it means that the sound produced by the cat is called as the purring sound. Okay, purring. And it was also sweating its pen. Sweating means hitting with something. Okay, in order to attract the attention of the narrator, it was also sweating at his pen time and again in order to catch attention. So suddenly one Sunday afternoon, what did the narrator notice, or what did Zan notice? He noticed that through the seams of the ceiling, what was coming out? Smoke was coming out, and slowly and gradually, what happened? That entire smoke, it engulfed the entire room, or this smoke, it engulfed, or it covered the entire area of the room, and they were just groping in the smoky area in the dark to find out the main door to the yacht. Okay, so finally, they were able during that time. He has no idea of his cat. No idea of his mom. Finally, when they found out the door, they came out into the yard. When they came out into the yard, he has seen that his entire house, it was in flames. It was really burning down. Okay. Then, at that time, what happened? His mother, she immediately went back into the room. Why she went back into the house? She went back into the house in order to save the important documents which are related to the house. But before that, she was also concerned about the letters as well as the photographs of her husband. As the narrator's father was dead when he was a young child, so she never wanted that last piece of memory to be lost forever. She wanted to rescue all these things. She went inside the house, came out with the metal box and had thrown over onto the ground into the yard. Then again, when she went inside, so the narrator knew clearly what she was after about. She went inside. Narrator was running behind her mother in order to stop her from going into the burning house. But suddenly he was held back by someone. Why was he held back? Because by the time he was busy in all that scene, he did not notice that the fireman has arrived. Okay, so one of the men, he held him back because he was not acting logically. It was not wise for him to go into the burning house to save his mother. And ultimately, that fireman also assured him that the other firemen would definitely save his mother. Right? Clear till here? Okay, so main things what we have learned here is what advice was given by his teachers. What advice was given by his teachers? Yes, he should indulge in various kind of activities so that he could make new friends and would be able to adjust in the new school environment. Right? Then afterwards, what did the narrator notice one Sunday afternoon? Okay, yes. The entire room was filled with smoke. Why did the narrator's mother go to the house back? Yes, she wanted to save the letters as well as the photographs that were related to narrator's father, as narrator's father was dead when he was a young child, and she never wanted that this last piece of memory to be lost forever. Okay, and why was the narrator held back by the fireman? Yes, because he was not acting logically. He wanted to save him from going into the burning house, because it was not at all wise to go into the burning house, and she would also be a victim to the burning house. And ultimately, the fireman also assured him that his mother would be saved. So finally, what came after that? That his house was completely burned. After 5 hours, the fire was under control, and he noticed that when the fireman rescued her mother, she was choking. She took him to the fire brigade van, in which she was given oxygen in order to breathe properly, and also the fireman also also you can say assured him that his mother will be fine within no time. Finally, when the house was burned, they did not have anything in order to they did not have anything with them to buy new things. So finally, where they have gone after that? They have gone to their grandparents' house. One night was spent at grandparents' house, as all the, you can say, all the important documents of the banks, all the cards and all the information and all the identities, they were burnt in the house. So they did not have anything on their part in order to withdraw money from the bank. So finally, they spent one night at their grandparents' house, and they had to borrow money from them also. Okay, so clear, why did they spend one night at their grandparents' house and why did they borrow money? Okay, right, fine. Okay, then afterwards, the next day, that is Monday, he did not skip the school. He went to the school. But how he was feeling? He was feeling like a zombie. He was feeling strange. He was feeling surreal. He was feeling like a geek. What are the reasons for all this? Okay. Because when he was going to school, he was without any uniform. He did not have any clothes to wear for the school. What he was wearing his Sunday church clothes, which he was wearing when he went to the church the previous day. Moreover, he was without any pair of shoes, and he has to borrow a pair of shoes from his aunt, that were the tennis shoes. He borrowed a pair of tennis shoes from his aunt, and he was without any backpack, without any books, and without any homework. He was just having a feeling of strangeness, or like a strange person, like a zombie. He was moving around the school, and ultimately this word spread around the school about his condition. He said that poor, that bad things, they spread quickly. This really happened in his case also. He said, in my case it was not different. He said, I gathered the attention of everyone with pitiful eyes looking at him. But he said, I have never demanded this kind of attention. He said, I wanted attention, but not this kind of attention I ever demanded. And after that, what happened? That when everyone was looking at him, he felt that he was responsible for all this, what has happened. So here the question is, why did the narrator feel that he was responsible for all that has happened to him? Why he felt so? He felt so because everyone was looking at him with pitiful eyes, and he never demanded such kind of attention. And the word about his poor condition, about his this strange situation, it spread around the world, around the school also. Moreover, he was a new student to the school also, and without any friends, he was feeling surreal and he was feeling strange in the new school. Then afterwards, he said, the next day, when everybody came to know, when he was preparing for his gym class, he was standing near the locker, he was arranging all the things and was changing his clothes. Everyone was moving around him. They were just showing him, pushing him to the gym. He was just, you can say, sorry, he in a surprising manner was thinking, and why did the people, they are behaving with him in this manner? So actually he felt really very strange at that time, and was having a strange feeling in his mind. And that moment when he entered into the gym, so what he noticed there, that a large table was set up in front, in the main hall of the gym, and all the important things related to the school, including books, notebooks, okay, track suits, track pants, sweat suits, everything was arranged for him. And how did he feel at that time? He felt like a Christmas presents were being given to him. It was really a genuine outpouring of concern that has been shown to him by his friends of the new school. So on that day, he also got many invitations from his friends in order to come to their house. And on that day, he has made many new friends. So the loss that he was feeling, the void he was feeling in his life of the loss of his friendship, it is going to be filled. Okay? It is going to be filled. He has lost his old friends, but now within few days, he has got his new friends. So at that moment, he was filled with the sense of security. He was feeling that he is no longer at loss, slowly and gradually everything to be on the track. Preacher, why are you laughing again and again? I'm not cracking a joke here. Then afterwards, By the time after one month, the entire house is going to be rebuilt again. He was sitting on the bench and just watching his house to be rebuilt again, which has once turned out to be a heap of rubble. And at that moment, what happened when he was sitting with his new friends, 2 to 3 new friends, and a lady came from behind and she asked for his name. And when he looked around, he found that his red tabby cat, it was brought by that woman. He immediately leapt up, jumped, and took the cat out from her hands, and he was feeling again a sense of security. The loss he has felt, it is going to be filled up, because the red tabby cat, which was quite dear to him, is back. And the narrator said, with the revival of this life, so was he. Again, his life was completely, you can say, it has been brought to the trap. Okay, so it means that what the narrator is going to deliver here is that we people suffer different kind of losses, sometimes unexpected things that happen in our life, but that ultimately doesn't give an end to our life. We have to stand again. We have to formulate our own opinions. We have to adjust, and life is another name of adjustment. This we have learned from this chapter. So with that, I think that everything is clear to you now. All the important parts, that's clear. Stand up, you now. Just explain for a while.
He felt that all the things were on, but his mother and outside friend passed.
Okay, sit down, please. Sit down. Thank you. Sit down. So, when the narrator's mother was brought back by the fireman, what kind of emotional change he felt? What thing he remembered at that time? He remembered the moment when number of times he was against his mother, number of times when he felt indifferences for his mother, that all to be vanished at one time. So there were number of emotional changes that were happening to him. Okay, clear?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Why did the author's mother? She went back to the yard again. Yes. Akshit lost. Why did the author's mother went back to the house again, to the burning house again? To see what? Sit down. Yes. Saksham. And the other memories which were related to him. She never wanted that the last thread of memory to be lost forever. He wanted to get these, he wanted to save, he wanted to rescue those precious memories, which was the last, you can say, memory of her beloved husband. Yes, Paramveer. How did the narrator revive his sense of security back in the end? How did the narrator, he was feeling a sense of security in the end? Okay. Yes, Vivan, sit down. How did the narrator feel the sense of security back in his life again?
When he was able to make his friends, and by having his beloved cat in his life.
Mainly three things are there. He got his friends back, house was built again, and ultimately his dear cat was back. Okay, clear? So, now next afterwards, we are going to start with the chapter, The Beggar. So what the chapter The Beggar is all about?
Test
I will send after that. Now, no. Now, the chapter The Beggar. In the chapter The Beggar, Sarji, who is an advocate, a lawyer, he has met a waif. Waif means a beggar on the street. Okay? So, the beggar was demanding attention from Sarji and he wanted to give him some alms as he did not have any money in order to accommodate his life also. So, Sarji was little bit, you can say, Sarji was trying to help the beggar, and immediately what happened? The beggar, he has made two different kind of excuses. Okay, first of all, in front of Sarji at that time, what excuse was made by the beggar? That he was once working as a school teacher, but he has met, you can say, calumny, or he has some intriguing plan made by his companions because of which he has lost his job. He said that now there is a post vacant, or there is a vacancy in Kaluga for which he is going to appear in the interview, but as he is obliged by his circumstances, he did not have any money to go there. So this is the reason his circumstances was compelling him to ask for money from all. So just because of this reason, he was begging in the streets. The other moment when Sarji, he had a glance, or he has paid a look towards his shoes. What kind of shoes was he was wearing? One was high and one was low. At that moment, Sarji remembered that he has seen this beggar at some other point. Then he remembered he has seen this beggar the other day in Savodhya Street. So what the beggar? He said that he had seen this beggar in Savodhya Street. And there at that time, what excuse was made by the beggar? He was making an excuse. What excuse was made by the beggar at that time? He was making an excuse that he was a college student who has been expelled from the college. This really, so when Sarji announced his, you can say, about his life, the beggar felt abashed. He was surprised. He felt mumbled. Stop afterwards. I will send you. Sit down, please. Then he felt abashed. Ultimately, he was surprised. He was trapped in his words. This really made Sarji to have a disgusting expression on his face. He thought that it is really swindling that he is cheating in the streets and asking for alms in this manner. Later on, he asked that he will call the police in order to tackle the matter so that he would not be able to ask for alms and making different kind of lies at the making different kind of lies in the streets. Now, as this beggar, he was trapped in his own words. He was not able to speak even a single word. Okay, this made him to speak the reality. He said, "Sir, I want to tell you the reality that he was working in a Russian choir. He was singing in a Russian choir, but because he was a drunkard, so that this is the reason why he has been, you can say, fired from the band." And he said, "This is the reason why I am asking for alms. And if I would tell this reality to the people, they would never give me any money. These circumstances are forcing me to beg money." Even the flush, red flush on the eyes, on the both the cheeks of the beggar, this also, as well as the swollen eyes of the beggar, this also revealed this fact that he was a drunkard. Sarji, who wanted to help that beggar, he told him that he would take him to his house and would offer him a point and would offer him a job to chop the wood. So Sarji offered him to take him to his house so that a work to be provided to him, and he would chop some wood for him every time he would come to their house, and ultimately he would also earn some money. To this, as the beggar, he was trapped in his own words, he had no choice, so he went along with Sarji. Sarji took him to his house, and when he reached the house, he called his cook Olga. Okay, what is the name of the cook? Olga. He called his cook Olga. When she came, she was directed to take him to the backyard of the house, where under a shed, some billets of wood, logs of wood, they were settled up, and he was given a job of chopping the wood. Okay, so after that, next, we are going to revise the next lecture.